Hey guys, I think the last time I talked to you, I was about to get, I just had ordered the update to the ECU for my Triumph Thruxton R, given that from the Diva Danielle. Well, I did get that in, and that was revision 6. And what you do that is you on your Android, and you use a dongle to your ODB2 port, and it takes about 15 minutes to load it. Didn't have any problems at all. Took it out. It was revision 6 is what I got the first time, and it ran real well. Had taken the Power Commander 5 off, and completely off, and it's just running on the new tune. Ran really well. Diva Danielle came back a little bit later and said, I think I have something that can improve that. It's made for the US version of a Cam Thruxton. So I put that on, and that was version 1. And I intended to take it back to, and go and get it dyno tuned. In fact, any day now is when I was going to do that. Take it over to Seattle, Washington, near Seattle, Washington, a place called Kirkland, Washington. Kirkland, Washington is in the news now because they've had 5 of the 6 deaths of the COVID-19 virus there. And they weren't really sure of how many people went in and out of that place before they found out that they had the virus. So I'm postponing the trip to Kirkland, Washington to do the dyno run. And I let Diva Danielle know that because I was going to give her some of those inputs. She sent me another version of the cartoon for the Cam version of the Thruxton based off the TFC. And I have loaded that. It takes about 15 minutes to load. It goes easy peasy. And I'm pretty technologically, I'm not savvy, but it's not hard to do. So what I've done, I'm gonna take the bike for a ride tomorrow, put some new spark plugs in, just to make sure we're gonna check the heat range, see how it runs. So we're gonna take it. If everything turns out all right, we'll leave that tune in. Still gonna plan to take it to the dyno. However, I think what we're gonna do is take it to the drag strip first. At the end of this month, going out to the drag strip. My drag strip is about 2,900 feet, and I'm going to run it out there. Got a good baseline off of my other runs. We've run it about 37 times out there with different configurations, and I know what this configuration run before the tone and before the cam. I don't know what it will run with it after. We're shooting for the high 11s. We've got it down to 12.055, and if the track is, the temperature cooperates, and I don't screw it up, then I think we'll be fine. The part that I may have to switch out is, I've got a Corbin seat that I use on the bike, but I've noticed with, since I've got the tunes in, I slide a lot on the Corbin seat when you give it to beans. So I have finished my break in. I did 500 miles easy peasy on the bike, on the cam. Did an oil change and filter. Didn't notice anything bad. The oil's pretty thin when you come out of there with only 500 miles on it. But I took it easy. Very seldom I've got above 4,000 RPMs in the first 500 miles. But I did check it out. We're gonna take it out tomorrow. We're gonna do a spark plug check. So we're gonna take it out. We'll run it up in 6th gear, chop the throttle, and pull the plugs and make sure that we're doing pretty good. I think version 2, according to Danielle, has a little bit more fuel at the top end. And then we'll check that out. I do have a good reading on the flux before this, and I can do comparison between version 1 and version 2 of this, as well as the R6 version she gave me. So what I'm going to use, if it runs well, we'll leave it. When we're ready to go to Bonneville, I may have to change the tune, because out of Bonneville, which we're running in 2021, at Bonneville you have less air, so you naturally it's going to get richer out there, because you're running anywhere from 4,500 feet to density altitude is up to 7,000. So you've got to make some allowances for that. So let you take a look at the bike, and we'll let you know how it runs. We'll be doing, like I said, we'll be doing the drag strip runs March 29th or 30th, and I should have something up after that to show you how the bike ran. Thanks.
This is what the bike's going to look like going to the drag strip. Of course, it won't have saddlebags. I'll take those off, probably leave the mounts on. It's not that big a problem. Tank bag will come off. The mirrors will come off. We're going to leave the quarter fairing on. I'm going to be running with those awesome Meerkat reverse megaphones. They are a treat to listen to, although they're a little loud and probably not the best thing for a long day of riding, but for the short rides and the drag strip and Bonneville, they're great. I really like those. Thank you, Peter. And this is when we get ready to go to Bonneville, we'll change out the fairing on it. We'll put the full fairing on it. I'll show you that in just a minute. But this is my shop. It's not the best organized shop. I've got a lot of my Bonneville stuff up, and road racing things and drag racing things, and you can kind of get an idea. Okay, this is the other part of my shop. Kind of got some tools and things out here, but this is the fairing that I'll be putting on the silver bike. I've ran it once with it, and it runs pretty good with it. Just have to lower the handlebars down very low in order to make it work. Thanks for watching.